everybody. It is Captain Starlight here. I am coming to you live in the Starlight Express Room on Starlight TV across the country and also on Facebook Live. So hello to all our Facebook Live friends. Guys, I am super duper excited because we have a really, really special guest joining us today for our Starlight stream. We have the Australian children's entertainer and musician, Peter Combe.
Good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
I'm very good. It's very warm and sunny down here in Adelaide today.
That is good. Thank you so much for joining us, Peter.
It's okay.
So I hear today we are going to be singing some favorite songs and hearing about a new song, because I believe that you have a greatest hits tour coming up.
I do, yes. It was a greatest hits tour designed for this year. And of course, with COVID hitting back in March, the whole tour has been postponed, except for the one show in Adelaide, which is happening at the end of the 12th at the beautifully newly renovated Her Majesty's Theatre in the city. It's gorgeous.
Beautiful.
Sydney and Melbourne shows have also been rescheduled for April next year and probably Canberra as well. So the tour is slowly being reassembled.
Yeah, wonderful. At least you get to do one in Adelaide at the end of this year. That's very exciting.
Well, it's a big show. I do solo shows as well, but this is my big show with the whole band, the Belly Flop and the Pizza Band, and the fabulous Kumets, who are six gorgeous kids who do backing vocals for me, and I'll be using the band and the kids in all the shows all around Australia when I do them.
Wow, that sounds like so much fun! Is the concert for all ages, Peter?
Oh yeah, I think so. I think I'd probably say. A 2-year-old wouldn't last the distance. A 3.5 is okay. I would sort of say to parents, look, I think 3.5 upwards is fine. It's a fairly long show. It goes for with interval close on 2 hours, and there'll be some lovely projections. So there's visual stuff going on as well as the audio.
Wonderful.
I'm very excited about it because it's the show that people have been asking me to do for years and years and years. They say things like, in your show, will you be doing wash your face, nourish your, will you be doing toffee apple? Will you be doing will you be doing spaghetti bolognese? And the answer is yes.
Yeah, that's what we want. Amazing. Well, that is so exciting. And now, guys, because we have people watching on Starlight TV across the country and also on our Facebook Live, Peter, we are going to be having people send in questions. So if you're watching right now and you want to send in a question to ask Peter, you can send that through and we can ask throughout the segment. So I also have another really exciting thing, because we're going to be listening to some of your favorite songs, Peter, and one of them involves some newspaper. Now, I'm not sure if you guys know the song Newspaper Mama, but we will be doing a craft activity coming up later on. So grab your newspaper or even normal paper and maybe some sticky tape, because later on we will be making a newspaper hat all together. But first, Peter, I believe you have a new song to share with us.
I do. I put out an album in 2017 called Live It Up, and I always wanted to write a climate change song for children. Because I feel a responsibility as someone who's, you know, been doing this for a long time, that children are the ones who are going to really bear the brunt of climate change coming up and, you know, the rest of this century. So I wanted to write a song just to kind of not be alarmist, but just to alert them to the fact that this is a real thing. And so I wrote this song called Sun Comes Up, Sun Goes Down. It's very easy to sing.
Yeah, well, whenever you're ready.
Okay, let me just get my backing track up. I'm going to have that choir with me as well. Otherwise,
no worries.
So this is Sun Comes Up, Sun Goes Down. Just to look after. Sun comes up, sun
that is the human race, living in a perfectly beautiful place.
The earth is getting warmer, the oceans are rising higher, the storms are growing stronger, floods and fires. We must have changes. The future is in our hands.
Sun comes up, sun goes down. Every day, all year round. Let it all, human race. Living in a perfectly beautiful place. Sun comes up, sun goes down. Every day, all year round. Let it all, human race, living in a perfectly beautiful place. Sun comes up, sun goes down, every day, all the year around. And it's a human race, living in a perfectly beautiful place. Living in a perfectly beautiful place. Living in a perfectly beautiful place.
Thank you so much, Peter.
Okay.
That's a wonderful song. Congratulations. That's awesome.
Thank you. Thank you.
So good. Because I hear that you have a new album called Live It Up, I believe.
Yes, Live It Up came out. We toured the album back in 2017, went to all the capital cities. Yeah. And that was one of the songs we did from the album. So it's but I think it's just very important for children to know about climate change. Because there's a lot of misinformation about it. But probably the best person to actually, if you want to watch something about climate change, watch David Attenborough's last film. Because if anyone knows about it's David Attenborough, because he's actually been to almost every part of the world over the last 60 years.
Pretty amazing.
It's David Attenborough.
Yeah, that is for sure. Now, I'm going to check in our chat here because we have had some questions sent through, which is pretty exciting. So we have one from Ivy Sward. She is 6 years old and her mum wants to know, there's two parts to this question, what was the inspiration behind Mr. Clickety Kane? And also, do you remember the kids that danced on stage in the video? Because Ivy's mum was actually one of the kids in that video.
Really?
Okay. Amazing.
Well, the video, part of that video was performed in Adelaide, so I presume she's an Adelaide girl. I don't have a really clear memory about why I wrote Mr. Clickety Kane. I'll explain that. The songwriting is a very mysterious thing. For example, I have a very clear memory of why and how I wrote Spaghetti Bolognese, but the thing about Piggity Cane or Wash Your Face and Orange Juice is I remember where I wrote it. I wrote it on a piano in our house. Someone's writing piano. This is written on piano. And I remember the room I wrote it in, but I don't remember why I wrote it. But what I can say, it's kind of been one of those songs that's crept up on me and everyone else over the past 35 years. It was never a title track in an album. It was always track number three on Spaghetti Bolognese, but it's become
it's huge.
Song.
So yeah.
I wish I could remember more about how I wrote it, but I know it came fairly quickly. It's kind of a, I suppose you can say it's a quintessentially typical children's song with accumulative echoes, and echoes are always very powerful things to put in children's songs. Kids can learn them like straight away. So the audience have never heard this song before, and they can all sing the echo. So, so that's the story of Mr. Clickety Kane.
That's awesome. All right, we might have time for one more before we move on. But we had a question from Darla, who is 7 years old, and with the same song. She wants to know, is orange juice a good face wash for pimples?
I think it'll be brilliant.
Brilliant.
You'd believe me if I said that, wouldn't you? It's brilliant. Perfect thing to wash your face with.
Have you tried washing your face with orange juice, Peter?
Actually, don't tell him, but actually I haven't, no. I also haven't tried belly flopping into a pizza, but I know a lot of adults who have, And to me, it all is painful.
Yeah, it sounds a little bit sticky to me, doesn't it? Well, since we're on the line talking about washing our face with orange juice, should we have a sing of one of the best songs, very well known from you, Peter?
And look, I'll sort of sing the echo as well, because it's a bit hard to do this online. But just please feel free to sing the echo, all right?
Yeah, I might even sing the echo with you.
I'll try it again. When Mr. Biggity came, Feliz the silly game, all the kids in the street, they like to do the same. Wash your face in orange juice.
Wash your face in orange juice.
The bubble gum. Clean your teeth with bubble gum. I'll just turn you down a bit. Try it again.
Oh, no worries.
Biggity came, Feliz the silly game, all the kids in the street, they like to do the same. Wash your face in orange juice.
Wash your face in orange juice.
With bubble gum.
Clean your teeth with bubble gum.
Sticky tape. When Mr. Biggity came, Feliz the silly game, all the kids in the street, they like to do the same. Wash your face in orange juice. Clean your teeth with bubble gum. I fix the fence with sticky tape. Brush your hair with a toothbrush. Fry your neck in the slippery dip. When Mr. Biggity came, Feliz the silly game, all the kids in the street, they like to do the same. Wash your face in orange juice.
Wash your face with orange juice.
With bubble gum.
Clean your teeth with bubble gum. Fix the fence with sticky tape.
Brush your hair with a toothbrush.
Brush your hair with a toothbrush.
Fry an egg on a slippery dip.
Fry an egg on a slippery dip.
Belly flop on a pizza.
Belly flop on a pizza.
Belly flop into a pizza. I've sung this song 2,500 times, and no one wants to belly flop into a pizza. They all think it's disgusting. And just possibly, yuck. When Mr. Biggity came, Feliz the silly game, all the kids in the street, they like to do the same. All the kids in the street, they like to do the same. All the kids in the street, they like to do the same. Silly game. There it is.
There it is. I'm surprised nobody has tried it. Maybe someone will want to after watching this stream. Who knows?
People have definitely tried washing your face in orange juice.
Yeah. All right. We've got a few people. We have Belinda, Dana, Tori, and David from Facebook who all think you sound great and want to say hi, Peter. Hello. We have a question from Harry, who is 5 years old, and he wants to know, what is your favorite Lego, and also what is your favorite song?
What's my favorite Lego?
Yeah.
Not quite sure what he means, or what's my favorite Lego. I do play Lego with my little granddaughter, Holly, and she'd always ask me to build a house. So I guess building a house is what I've done the most of with Lego. And the other question was, what was the other question? I've forgotten what it was.
Your favorite song.
My favorite song. Oh, yeah, that's a hard one, you know, because the songs I sing, I guess the songs I don't sing quite so often, ones I love to sing the most. There's a song on the Newspaper Mummery album called All Good Things that I love to sing.
Okay, and there's also a
song on my Christmas album called Love and Joy, which I also love to sing. But, you know, I still enjoy singing Wash Your Face and Newspaper Mummery and all those as well. But,
yeah.
I like to sing something different every now and then.
Yeah, that is great. Awesome. I love singing.
I like ballady songs as well, where I can actually use my upper tenor range. That's always nice.
Yeah.
So that's why All Good Things and Love and Joy, they use my higher voice, which I always enjoy doing.
Yeah, awesome. Well, everybody go and have a listen to those other songs as well. Okay, now, guys, it is time for our craft activity. Now, Peter, if you feel like joining in, if you have a piece of paper around, feel free. But if not, we are going to make one all together. So if you are watching on Starlight TV or on the Facebook Live, you're going to need to grab a piece of paper, preferably a newspaper, but sometimes we don't have those lying around too much anymore, do we? So what you're going to want to do, you got your piece of paper. Is that a sheet music, Peter?
Actually, it's some lyrics. I'm going to tear off the lyrics. I'm going to tear off some lyrics with the spaghetti bolognese written on it. Okay? So I'm going to make a spaghetti bolognese newspaper mama hat.
That sounds incredible. All right. So once you have your piece of paper, you want to pop it in landscape. So up this way. And we're going to want to fold it in half, everybody. So fold it directly in half, just like so, kind of like a book. Folding it in half. Awesome.
Okay, I'll copy you. Okay. I'll show you my own method, but I'll copy you instead.
Oh, okay. All right. Maybe you can show us after. So we've got it in landscape. We fold it in half. We're going to unfold it, and now we're going to pop it horizontally and fold that in half again. Super fancy, these newspaper hat making.
Very complicated.
Very complicated. All right. Now, what you're going to want to do is you're going to keep it in horizontal, and you're going to fold the corners up to meet the line, like so. Does that make sense? Yeah. Let's have a look.
All four of them?
All four of them. Just the top two.
Just the top two. Oh, yeah, top two. Yep.
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 Amazing. Okay. So then once you've got them folded like so, they should look a little bit like this.
Yep.
Kind of looks like a paper airplane.
Yeah.
But it's going to be a hat. Awesome. And then what you want to going to do is grab this bottom part and fold it up like this make a brim on both sides. Just folding it up. And then you pop it open and you've got your newspaper hat.
I think I stuffed it up.
You should have done your own technique, Peter.
I'll do it again. I'll do it again. What I think might work for me. Let's have a look.
Yeah, you show us your way.
No, I don't look at my way. No, don't follow me. I thought I knew how to make a head actually, but not working out. Never mind. Yeah. Ignore mine.
No worries. All good. Yours will just turn into spaghetti bolognese. But if you want to add a string, you can add a little bit of sticky tape on the inside, and then you can pop it. Yours amazing.
That's how mine was meant to look, but yours was much better. that's very nifty.
And to all our friends in the Starlight Express room and on Facebook Live, if you want to send a photo, you can leave it in the comment on Facebook so we can see your newspaper hats. Now, we have made our hats. We have talked about your album. We've talked about your tour, which is super, super exciting. Should we sing the song that goes along with these newspaper hats, Peter?
What a good idea. Shall we sing the major? And I hope I can do a better job of singing the song than I did of making my hat.
No worries.
Actually, can you just let me just quickly retune the guitar? It's just gone slightly out of tune. Hang on a sec.
Of course. And if you are watching, make sure to sing along the echoes, because Peter is going to sing, and then you and I, you can sing with me, Captain Starlight, and we can sing the echoes back to Peter. So this is Newspaper Mama. So get your newspaper hats ready. If you have less hats on your head like me, you could wear it on top, but I'm going to hold it on the side. But let's get ready.
I think we're done. I'm going to turn you down, Captain Starlight, otherwise the echo comes back slightly out of phase.
No worries.
Ready to go?
Ready to go.
Here we go. What's black?
What's black?
And what's white?
What's white?
Red all over.
Red all over.
Every day. Newspaper mama. Every day. What's thrown? Over the fence. Over the fence.
Into the garden.
Every day. Newspaper mama. Every day. Read it over breakfast every Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, especially on Sunday. Best day of all. What's black?
What's white?
White. Red all over. Every day. Newspaper mama. Every day. Now what do you get? When you open the door. Every morning.
Of every day.
Newspaper mama.
newspaper mama ever reads it. Pick up the newspaper mama, newspaper mama, newspaper mama ever reads it. And that's it.
Yay! Amazing. I wonder if everyone was dancing along with their newspaper hats, Peter. So good.
It's a bit of a dancey song, that one, yeah.
It is, right? It's so much fun. Well, thank you so much, Peter. Thank you for joining us this morning. I had so much fun. I hope everyone watching on Starlight TV and on our Facebook Live had a good time as well. Let's just double check. You've got a new album called Live It Up.
Yep.
You have some tours. When are they? Yes. You've got some in November in Adelaide?
Yes, December the 12th in Adelaide at the gorgeous theatre here called Her Majesty. Yeah. It's just had $30 million spent on it, so it's just gorgeous.
Whoa, I did
a little thing, the interview on Sunrise Channel 7 a few days ago. It's just beautiful. And the other two shows, I'm doing Sydney on April the 7th in a place called the Riverside Theatre in Parramatta, another beautiful theatre.
Yeah.
And I'm probably doing Canberra on the 10th of April at the Canberra Theatre. That's not totally confirmed yet, but pretty likely. And the other one that is confirmed is the Melbourne Recital Centre on April the 13th. And that's also a beautiful place to come and see a show.
So
I'm hopefully also doing a show in Hobart as well, but I haven't got a confirmed date for that yet.
Yeah, exciting. Great. Well, thank you so much for your time. We also want to give a shout out to the Starlight Express Room in Alice Springs. They are watching right now and they are loving the stream and they say hi, Peter.
Hello.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much for joining us, everybody. Peter, any last words for our watchers? Maybe should they try and fry an egg on a slippery dip today?
I think so. If it's mid 30 degrees, why not?
Yeah, maybe in Alice Springs particularly, hey.
Any day in Alice Springs, and I think any day in Darwin too.
Yeah, that is true. Well, thank you so much for your time, Peter. It has been a pleasure.
My pleasure too.
Thank you so much. And thank you everybody on Starlight TV and across on our Facebook Live. Thank you so much for joining us. It has been an amazing morning. I'm sure your newspaper hats or paper hats turned out fabulously. And thank you so much for watching. We will be posting the highlights on our YouTube channel, Starlight Kids TV. So if you've missed it, no fret. It's all good. That will be up there. And that is all. Thank you so much for sending through your questions. Thank you to Peter. Had so much fun. And maybe don't try belly popping on a pizza. But if you try and fry an egg on a slippery dip, let us know how it goes. Well, it has been Captain Starlight. Thank you so much. And we will see you next time. Bye.